Gurunji Senior Secondary School, CBSE, Namakkal.
Successful, result-producing school in state every year.
Administered by the Board of Directors with over 35 years of experience in the teaching field.
Special attention on art, craft, music, dance, silambam, yoga, skating and karate.
Focus on Hindi Sabha and Spell Bee Olympiad exams.
Smart class for effective and innovative learning and well-furnished library.
Solitary importance on sports and games in state and national level.
WhatsApp facilities to know activities of students and school inside the campus.
NEET, JEE, IIT coaching experts from Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh along with our effective teachers.
Admission registration for classes LKG to plus 2.
Kurunji Educational Institution, Kavetipatti, Namakkal. Admission in progress. CBSE, KG to 12, contact 9025895176. Metric 6 to 12, contact 9344567484. For online admission, log on to www.kurunjischoolnkl.in.
Hi students, with this class, we are going to start new chapter to discuss numericals. The chapter is electromagnetic induction. Electromagnetic induction. Okay, right. See this example 6.1. First, we will see example problems. Then, we will go for exercise and additional exercise problems. Okay, right. First problem, example 6.1. See here. Consider experiment 6.2. So, here I drew one picture. You can see this. You can see one picture. See here. So, based on this picture, this is what experiment 6.2. Consider experiment 6.2. There are two things he is asking to discuss. One is, what would you do to obtain a large deflection of the galvanometer? A large deflection of the galvanometer. Next, B is, how would you demonstrate the presence of an induced current in the absence of galvanometer? So, based on this experiment, this is what the experiment, this is what coil 1, coil 2, galvanometer, and it is what a battery, okay, or cell which produces the current. So, you know that when the current, the magnitude of current, right? So, when the current is changing, when the electric current is changing in one coil, so in the nearby coil also, the EMF will be developed and you can experience induced current in the neighboring coil. That is what Faraday's experiment. So, based on this experiment, he is asking two things. One is, what would you do to obtain a large deflection of the galvanometer? That is one. And next, B is, how would you demonstrate the presence of an induced current? The presence of an induced current in the absence of galvanometer. Okay, right. See this. First solution A. To obtain a large deflection, one or more of the following steps can be taken. So first A is he is asking about large deflection only, no? So in A he is asking, to obtain a large deflection of the galvanometer, what we have to do? So to obtain large deflection, we have to do the following things. One is, use a rod made of soft iron inside the coil C2. Okay. So, one is, use a rod made of soft iron inside the coil C2. Second one is, connect the coil to a powerful battery. And third one is, move the arrangement rapidly towards the test coil C1. Move the arrangement rapidly towards the test coil C1. Okay. So with these three things, we can increase large deflection, right? So we can get large deflection. To obtain a large deflection, there are three ways. That's why here 1, two, three. One is use a rod made of soft iron inside the coil C2. Second one is connect the coil to a powerful battery. And third one is move the arrangement rapidly towards the test coil C1. With these three things, we can obtain large deflection. Next, B. In B, what he is asking? How would you demonstrate? How would you demonstrate the presence of an induced current in the absence of galvanometer? In the absence of galvanometer, right? Nice question. See here. Replace the galvanometer by a small bulb. So this is the position of galvanometer. He is saying that replace the galvanometer by a small bulb. The kind one finds in a small torchlight. In small torchlight, we have seen a small bulb, no? So that bulb you connect here in place of galvanometer. Okay? The relative motion between the two coils will cause the bulb to glow. And thus demonstrate the presence of an induced current. Okay. So the question is, in the absence of galvanometer, how would you demonstrate the presence of an induced current? The answer is, in the place of galvanometer, you have to connect a small torchlight bulb. So when there is a relative motion between the two coils, and one coil is carrying electric current, that current is changing with the time. So time rate of change of current is present in one coil. Then in the nearby coil, automatically EMF will be induced. That EMF we can experience with a small torchlight bulb, which is connected in the place of galvanometer. So this is the experimental setup we can use to demonstrate the presence of induced current with the absence of galvanometer. Next example, example 6.2. Okay, example 6.2. See here. A square loop of side 10 cm and resistance 0.5 ohms is placed vertically in the east-west plane. Full stop. A uniform magnetic field of 0.1 Tesla is set up across the plane in the northeast direction. The magnetic field is described to zero. The magnetic field is decreased to zero in 0.7 seconds at a steady rate. Determine the magnitudes of induced EMF. Induced EMF and current during this time interval. Okay. See here. A square loop of side 10 centimeters and resistance 0.5 ohms is placed vertically in the east-west plane. A uniform magnetic field of 0.1 Tesla is set up across the plane in the northeast direction. The magnetic field is decreased to zero in 0.7 seconds. At a steady rate. He is asking to determine the magnitudes of induced EMF and current. During this time interval. See here now. See the solution. The angle theta made by the area vector of the coil. I hope you understood what is the area. Area means, suppose if this is the coil. In case of example 6.1, I showed you one experiment, right? That again I will show you. I think already you experienced many times, right? This is the coil, means this is the area of the coil, okay? So here the angle theta made by the area vector of the coil with the magnetic field is 45 degrees. We know that we know that the initial magnetic flux, what is the formula? Phi is equal to, okay, B bar dot A bar, and area is also vector and magnetic field is also a vector, and phi is equal to B bar dot A bar, that is equal to B A cos theta. Here B is, you know, 0.1, 10 centimeters he has given. Square loop of side, 10 centimeters given. So then if you convert this into meters, then what is that? 10 centimeters you have to convert into meters, because centimeters is the SI unit, centimeters is the CGS unit, So we have to convert into SI unit, that is what meter. But here we need area, So it is 10 centimeters means that we have to convert into area, we have to convert into meters, and then we have to substitute. Okay, what is the B value? B value is 0.1 Tesla, What is A value? That is here 10 to the power of minus 2. 10 to the power of minus 2. Next, this is what? It is 0.1 meter. 0.1 meter. 0.1 into 0.1 means it will become like 10 to the power of minus 2 divided by square root of 2. Square root of 2 means that is cos 45 degrees. You know the value of cos 45, it is 1 by root 2. So 0.1 into 10 to the power of minus 2 divided by root 2 Weber. Weber is the unit of flux. Now final flux is phi minimum, which is 0. It is the initial flux, it is BA cos theta, and final flux it is 0. Now the change in flux is brought about in 0.7 second according to the question. See here, the magnetic field is decreased to 0 in 0.7 seconds. So the change in flux is brought about in 0.7 seconds. See here, the magnitude of the induced EMF is given by, so that's, you know, epsilon is equal to modulus of delta phi b by delta t, that is equal to phi minus 0 divided by delta t, that is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 divided by square root of 2 into 0.7, because it is 10 to the power of minus 2, it is 10 to the power of minus 1, so 0.1 means you can say that it is 10 to the power of minus 1. So 10 to the power of minus 1 into 10 to the power of minus 2 means 10 to the power of minus 3 divided by, it is square root of 2 into 0.7, because it is time is there, right. So complete this process and finally we will get it as 1.0 millivolt, okay. That is what epsilon is 1.0 millivolt. Now see here, that is after completion of this, after getting this epsilon as 1.0 millivolt, and the magnitude of current, you know, the Ohm's law, that is I is equal to V by R. When I is equal to V by R, here I is equal to epsilon by R. So when I is equal to epsilon by R, see this, that is equal to epsilon is 1.0 millivolt, 1 millivolt, okay, 1 millivolt means it is 10 to the power of minus 3 volt, 10 to the power of minus 3 volt divided by 0.5 ohms. Resistance is a part of question. See here, 0.5 ohms. That is equal to 2 milliamps. That is equal to 2 milliamps. Okay, right. Next. Here they have given a small note. You please try to understand the note. The Earth's magnetic field. Earth's magnetic field also produces a flux through the loop. So because we are staying on the Earth, so Earth is a planet, we are believing that a huge magnet is buried inside the Earth, right? So when you buried a huge magnet inside the Earth, how it behaves? In that manner it is behaving, it is behaving, okay? That's why here the Earth's magnetic field also produces, a flux through the loop. That is, but it is a steady field and hence does not induce any EMF. I hope you understood the reason why we are not experiencing any EMF on our planet, that is Earth, okay? Because we are staying on surface of Earth, but we are not feeling, we are not experiencing any EMF. even though earth is behaving like a magnet, even though we are believing that a huge magnet is buried inside the earth, but we are not experiencing any EMF. The reason is it is a steady field. That is the reason. Okay, right, that is the only thing he want to say here. Next, example 6.3. Okay, see here. A circular coil of radius 10 centimeters, 500 turns. A circular coil of radius 10 centimeters, 500 turns, and resistance 2 ohms is placed with its plane perpendicular to the horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. Full stop. See here, its plane perpendicular to the horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. It is rotated about its vertical diameter through 180 degrees in 0.25 seconds. Then after, he is asking to estimate the magnitude of the EMF and the current induced in the coil. For that, they have also given horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field at the place is 3 × 10⁻⁵ Tesla. Okay, see here. A circular coil of radius 10 centimeters, 500 turns. A circular coil of radius 10 centimeters, 500 turns, and resistance 2 ohms is placed. Resistance, they have given 3 things regarding the coil. One is radius, another one is number of turns, another one is resistance. Is placed with its plane perpendicular to the horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. Okay, full stop. It is rotated about its vertical diameter through 180 degrees. In 0.25 seconds. Full stop. Estimate. Okay. It is rotated about its vertical diameter through 180 degrees in 0.25 seconds. Estimate the magnitudes of the EMF. And current induced in the coil. Further, they also given horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. At the place is 3.0 × 10⁵ Tesla. Okay. Now see the solution. Initial flux through the coil phi B, that is initial, is equal to BA cos theta. So this formula already we know, and we used the same formula in our previous example problems also, right? Here only we used, right? And B value is this one given, and A value is π × 10⁻². You know the formula for area of circle, pi r square. R is 0.1 meter. 0.1 meter means 10⁻⁻¹ meter, no? So here square is there. So 10⁻⁻¹ × 10⁻⁻¹, 10⁻⁻². So B A is pi r square into theta is 0. So when theta is 0, it is cos 0 and 1. So finally we are getting 3π × 10⁻⁷ Weber. Final flux after rotation, phi B final, it is 180 degrees. Okay, it is 180 degrees. 3π × 10⁻⁵ into π × 10⁻², into cos 180. Is minus 1, no? That is minus 3π × 10⁻⁷ Weber. Now, therefore, estimated value of the induced EMF is, epsilon is equal to capital N into d phi by dt. So that is what, N is 500, given number of turns, into d phi by dt. That is 6π × 10⁻⁷. divided by 0.25 seconds is the time. So if we complete this mathematical process, we will get it as 3.8 into 10 to the power of minus 3 volt. 3.8 into 10 to the power of minus 3 volt. Okay, right. This is what induced EMF, estimated value of the induced EMF. I is equal to epsilon by R. I is equal to epsilon by R. That is equal to 1.9 into 10 to the power of minus 3. I is equal to epsilon by R. That is equal to 1.9 into 10 to the power of minus 3 amps. That is what current value here. He is asking to find current also, no? First, he is asking to calculate magnitudes of the EMF. That's we got it as 3.8 into 10 to the power of minus 3 volt. Afterwards, he is also asking to calculate current induced in the coil. So current induced is by using Ohm's law, I is equal to epsilon by R. That is equal to 1.9 into 10 to the power of minus 3 amps. Okay, right. So there is a note. You please observe the note. The magnitudes of the epsilon and I are the estimated values. The magnitudes of epsilon and I are the estimated values. Their instantaneous values are different. Their instantaneous values are different and depend upon the speed of rotation at the particular instant. Depend upon the speed of rotation at the particular instant. That is what he is saying. So instantaneous values are different, ma, but these are the estimated values. Okay. So these instantaneous values are different and also depends upon the speed of rotation. Speed of rotation at the particular instant. At the particular instant. Okay. Right. So in this class we discussed three problems. In this class we discussed three example problems. So example 6.1, 6.2 and 6.3. Okay. Once you look at the example 6.1, in this example, by considering a small Faraday's experiment, he is asking two things. What we have to do to get large deflection, that is what A, and B is, he is asking, how would you demonstrate if galvanometer is not there? How would you demonstrate the experiment in the absence of galvanometer? So the answer is, you can obtain the large deflection by using a rod made of soft iron, inserting inside the coil C2 and then connecting the coil to a powerful battery. And the third one is, move the arrangement rapidly towards the test coil C1. So by doing these three things, or any one, whatever it may be, we will get or we will obtain a large deflection. Okay. Next, B is, he is asking, suppose if you don't have any galvanometer while doing this experiment, so what you will do? So it's a simple thing, ma. Just by using a small torchlight bulb, by replacing where we are connecting the galvanometer, in the same place, if you connect a torchlight, small torchlight bulb, so when there is a relative motion between the two coils and having a time rate of change of current in one particular coil, okay, then you can experience the glowing of small torchlight bulb. Then you can say that the induced EMF is present and induced current is also present. Okay, that's what you can conclude regarding example 6.1. And here itself, we also need to say, in experimental physics, right, one must learn to innovate, because Michael Faraday, who is ranked as one of the best experimentalists ever, was legendary for his innovative skills. So a small important point regarding our life. So through this point, he is saying that, so everything you have to see in experimental way, in experimental way of thinking. Okay, right. In the next example, in example 6.2, so they have given some of the quantities like radius, okay, side and resistance, and given magnetic field also. So finally he is asking the magnitude of induced EMF and currents. Okay, you know the formula for flux, that is BA cos theta. So first we calculated initial magnetic flux and then we calculated final flux, then change in magnetic flux, and this time they have given 0.70 seconds. And by using this formula, this is from Faraday's, right? Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. It is a mathematical form of Faraday's second law. Epsilon is equal to mod of delta phi b by delta t, and delta phi b means it is change in magnetic flux, ma, and substitute the numerical values what we have, then we are getting EMF, and then by using like Ohm's law you can get current. So it is the induced EMF and it is a induced current, okay. And there is also note, in that note what he is saying is, by staying on surface of earth, why we are not experiencing a magnetic flux? Means what he is saying is, so the earth's magnetic fields also produces a flux through the loop, but it is a steady field, that's why we are not experiencing, right, and hence does not induce any EMF. Next, in example 6.3 also they have given some data. So through that data he is asking to find induced EMF and induced current. The formula is same for induced, the formula is same for flux, that is BA cos theta. By substituting the values, you can calculate the initial flux and final flux, then change in flux. After completion of that, by using the formula, that is what second law, Faraday's second law of electromagnetic induction, epsilon is equal to n into d phi by dt, we are getting induced EMF. Thereafter, you can calculate induced current by using that I is equal to epsilon by R, okay. Here also the important note what he is saying is, the magnitudes of epsilon and I are the estimated values. Their instantaneous values are different and depend upon the speed of rotation at the particular instant. Okay, right. So in this class we discussed three example problems. Next class we will continue with example 6.4. Thank you.